Thank you so very much, David. I'm deeply honored to receive this honorary doctorate, which I accept on behalf not just of myself, but of the many outstanding students and postdocs who I've had the great privilege to work with during my scientific career, very much including you, David. It's a particular honor to receive this award from the University of York, where many of the luminaries of my own field are based. This includes not only David himself, but scientific leaders like Andy Young and Mike Burton, who are publishing the seminal papers on face recognition long before I got into the field, and Steve Tipper, who discovered the fascinating phenomenon of negative priming that inspired me and countless others to work on visual attention. But most importantly, I'd like to offer my congratulations to this year's graduates of the University of York. But what a time to be graduating. You're entering a world where a raging pandemic has already infected tens of millions of people and killed over a million human beings, where the likelihood is ever increasing that our planet may be irrevocably damaged by climate change, where the searing inequality of opportunity among our fellow human beings means that most do not have the privilege of the top-notch education you have all just received. So in addition to my congratulations, I want to offer my deepest apologies for the mess that my generation has left you. All of this happened on our watch. At the same time, though I don't at all think this gets my generation off the hook, the extraordinary challenges we now face are also extraordinary opportunities for each of you to have a major impact. You can work to phase out fossil fuels by developing new renewable energy technologies. You can run for office and fight for racial and economic justice. You can create beautiful art, music, or literature that lifts people's spirits. You can develop treatments for diseases. You can discover new things about the cosmos or the brain that blow people's minds. You can also, by the way, have a very big impact at a local level. Personally, I feel that one of the most important things I've done in the last decade is to call my mom every day in the final years of her life. Beyond all these aspirations, the grand and the small, lies a common driving force, and that is compassion for our fellow human beings. And I want to briefly share an important insight from my field of psychology that I think can help us all expand our compassion. And that is that many of the differences in our life outcomes are just due to raw dumb luck. Psychologists have shown that we tend to overinterpret randomness, seeing structure and inventing causal stories in what are basically just series of coin flips. Once we realize how prone we all are to seeing structure and cause where there is none, we can derive a few consequences. First and foremost, it means that other people are not so different from us. They're just different rolls of the same dice. Just societies recognize the deep inequities of random chance and compensate by spreading privilege and opportunity more evenly across the human family. It also means that we should spend less time congratulating ourselves for our successes and blaming ourselves for our failures. And to bring this out of the abstract, let me mention a few rolls of the dice that have landed me here today. First, my dad was a scientist, and my first publication was co-authored with him when I was barely out of college. From an early age, I had a front row seat on the thrill of a life in science, watching him work on whatever struck his fancy, setting off to the Arctic and Africa and the Amazon. My decision to pursue a career in science was not a courageous or innovative leap, but a gift of circumstance. Then in grad school, my luck turned for a few years, and I conducted experiment after experiment that just failed. In hindsight, they were perfectly reasonable experiments. I was just unlucky, fiddling with tiny effects that could come and go if you breathed on them. But at the time, I felt like a complete and total failure. And three times, I tried to just drop out of grad school. Which brings me to probably the greatest luck of my whole career. And that was to have the amazing and pioneering cognitive psychologist, Molly Potter, as my mentor. Molly calmly talked me out of quitting grad school again and again, with more patience than anyone can reasonably expect of an advisor. I'll spare you the many other flips of the coin in my life and just say that a lot of my success came from just turning up a lot of heads. So what do we do with this insight that much of luck and much of life is just raw dumb luck? Well, first, when things are looking bleak, don't fault yourself too much. Wait long enough in any run of tails and you're sure to turn up ahead. Second, be kind to others who are just down on their luck. That could be you next. And third, of course, luck is not enough on its own. You were all handed a great opportunity to attend the University of York, but you also worked very, very hard to get where you are today. So keep an eye out for each lucky opportunity. And when you see it, grab it and run with it. And don't forget to call your mom. Thank you.